Hello dear UPSC aspirants, welcome to Dr. Sharma's Hub of UPSC Preparation powered by the indiangurus.com. So we have already started with our daily current affairs courses from June onwards, June 2020 onwards. So hereby we are introducing through our indiangurus.com and Dr. Sharma's Hub of UPSC Preparation or YouTube channel, we are introducing a new course that is Indian Art and Culture for UPSC, state PSCs, SSC and various other government entrance examinations. If you see, art and culture is such a wonderful subject, such an interesting subject, but you know, around 50 to 60% of the aspirants of UPSC examinations, they find difficulty in solving the questions related to Indian art and culture. And also, since this is a volatile and vast subject, we are you know, here to help you to sail through your preparation for the Indian art and culture. This course consists of all the important and salient aspects of Indian art and culture, right from the ancient India to the modern India. And also this course contains all the previous year question papers which were asked in UPSC, CSE, SSC or you know, CDS and various other entrance examinations conducted by the UPSC. Okay, so let's start the Indian art and culture. This is India, our beautiful country, and it's known for its diversity and it's an amalgamation of diverse arts and culture and cultures. So basically, let's classify our Indian art first. The first one is Indian art. So Indian art, there are two types of arts. Number one, visual arts. Number two, performing arts. So visual arts, they include architecture, sculpture and pottery, and also Indian paintings. Architecture, sculpture, pottery and Indian paintings, these are the visual arts. That means we can see them. And next type of arts are the performing arts. That means these can be performed by the individuals who are specialized in this arts. So the first performing art is Indian music. Next is Indian dance. Next is Indian puppetry and martial arts. And after this, visual arts and performing arts, we shall also know about what are the various UNESCO's list of tangible and intangible cultural heritage. If you read the word tangible, that means literally it means it can be touched or it can be felt, whereas intangible, it can't be touched or it can't be felt. So after knowing about the visual arts and performing arts, we shall also know about the UNESCO's list of tangible and intangible cultural heritage. So let's start with so Indian art, and next important heading is Indian culture. So under Indian culture, we will read about Indian languages, the religion, the literature of India, the philosophy, the Indian philosophy, science and technology through ages, various Indian festivals and fairs, and India through the eyes of the foreign travelers. These topics are classified and carefully segregated according to the trends of the questions which are asked in the UPSC exam, especially UPSC Civil Services preliminary exam. So note down all these headings and note down all these keywords, and wherever you find some important article regarding these keywords, always read and write, make a note of it. So we will start with the most famous, most ancient, though very advanced civilization, that is the Indus Valley Civilization. So in this course, we will lay emphasis on the cultural part or the heritage part and the art and architecture part, not other historical aspects. So to start with, we are starting with the important sites of the Indus Valley Civilization. Various important sites of the Indus Valley Civilization and their archaeological significance or importance. So first one to start with is the city of Harappa. This great city of Harappa is present on the banks of which river? River Ravi. So you know IVC, Indus Valley Civilization, has flourished on the banks of the Indus and its tributaries. There are 5 tributaries of Indus River. Okay, so be very careful while locating the city. Harappa is located on the banks of Ravi River, not Satluj, not Chenab, not Bias, or not Indus exactly. So Harappa is located on the banks of the river Ravi, which is a tributary of the river Indus. And what are the important findings here in this Harappa? The 6 granaries, the stone symbol of Lingam and Mother Goddess, copper sculpture, sculpture of dog chasing a deer in bronze metal, and male torso which is made with red sandstone. These are the significant archaeological findings of the Harappa. If you can see, this is the Harappa city, and these are the granaries, the 6 granaries of the Harappa city. So here comes the question. There was a previous question in the UPSC CDS 2012 year. So the question says, the site of Harappa is located on the bank of which river? Which river? Just now we have read, it is located on the bank of river Ravi. It is not Saraswati, not Indus, not Bias. Answer is option number 4, that is Ravi. Now it's a very simple question for you. So next city is Mohenjo-daro. Mohenjo-daro, present in the present day Pakistan. Harappa is also located in the present day Pakistan. And this Mohenjo-daro is present on the banks of which river? The river Indus. So Mohenjo-daro is not present on the banks of river Ravi or Chenab or Satluj or Jhelum. This is located on the banks of the river Indus. And what are the findings? The great citadel, the great bath, the great granary, the sculpture of the bearded priest, the statue of the bronze dancing girl, and the seal of Pashupati. So these are the significant archaeological findings in the city of Mohenjo-daro. And if you can see in this beautiful picture, this is the great bath of Mohenjo-daro. And so there was a question in UPSC CAPF 2011. So there's a big paragraph describing a city, and you have to find out this paragraph is talking about which city. The following sentence describes one of the sites of the Harappan civilization. The settlement is divided into 2 sections, one smaller but higher and other much larger but lower. And archaeologists designate these as the citadel and the lower town, respectively. Both were walled. Several buildings were built on the platforms, which served as foundations. So, which of the following sites does it refer to? This directly refers to the city of Mohenjo-daro. See, this is a very, very, you know, meaningful paragraph. You can directly write in your mains exam also if there is some question to describe about the town planning of the Mohenjo-daro city. So the answer for this question is option 2, that is Mohenjo-daro. Next important site is Dholavira. Dholavira is in the present day Gujarat state. You can see this is the map. In this map there are various Harappan sites, the Indus Valley sites of the located in the Gujarat state. If you see, this is Dholavira, and this is Lothal. Number 1 Dholavira, number 2 Lothal, number 3 Sarkathoda, number 3 is Sarkathoda. These are the 3 important Indus Valley sites of the located in the Gujarat. So Dholavira, which is located in the Gujarat, is known for its giant water reserve. It is known for its stadium, known for its dams and well-developed water harnessing systems. And this Dholavira is the very recently or latest discovered Indus Valley civilization site or city. And here comes the question. This question is the match the following type of question. This question was asked in UPSC Civil Services Preliminary 2002. So here are the ancient sites, and in this column archaeological findings. First one is Lothal. So in Lothal, what was found? A dockyard was found in Lothal. So A2. Second, Kalibanga. In Kalibanga, a ploughed field was found. So B1. Dholavira, inscription of Harappan script is found. So C4. And in Banavali, terracotta replica of plough is found. So D3. So answer is A2, B1, C4 and D3. So make a note of all these sites and their archaeological findings. And next, there was one more question in UPSC CDS 2012. Which one among the following Indus cities was known for its water management? Just now we have read that Dholavira is known for its well-developed water harnessing system and also giant water reserve. So the answer is straightly Dholavira. Next important site is Lothal. This Lothal is also located in Gujarat, and this Lothal is known for its dockyard, rice husk, fire altars, painted jar, chess, terracotta figures of horse and also measuring scales. If you can see, this is the dockyard of Lothal, Gujarat, and through this dockyard, the Indus Valley people, they have established trade links with the one more advanced ancient civilization, that is the Mesopotamia or the present day Iraq. So there was a question in UPSC CDS 2007, which of the following sites of Indus Valley civilization had an ancient dockyard? Answer is straightly Lothal. It's very simple. And there was one more question in the quite very recent paper, that is UPSC CDS 2017. Which of the following Harappan sites is thought to have direct sea trade links with Mesopotamia? So just now we have read that Lothal has a dockyard and it had the trade links with Mesopotamia or Iraq. So the answer is Lothal. Next important site is Rakhi Gadi. This Rakhi Gadi is located in the present day Haryana. And Rakhi Gadi is known for its, the archaeological findings are granary, a cemetery, drains and also terracotta bricks. You can see these are the various terracotta articles or artifacts obtained from Rakhi Gadi of Haryana. Next important archaeological, Indus Valley site is Ropard. Ropard is located in the Punjab and this is located on the banks of River Sutlej. So always we can expect to match the following question. One column A, B. Here they will give you the Indus Valley site. One is Harappa. Second is Mohenjo-daro. Third is Ropard. And on B, they will give you the names of the rivers. Ravi, Satluj, Indus, etc. So we have to match the column A with column B with appropriate cities and their rivers. So the findings of Ropard are the dog which was buried with the human beings in the burials and also a copper axe. This is Ropard of Punjab. And other important sites are Kalibanga in Rajasthan, Sarkathoda in Gujarat, Banavali in Haryana, Alamgirpur in UP, and there are many other minor Indus Valley sites also. So these are the various important sites of Indus Valley civilization and their art and archaeological significance. So one more question, UPSC NDA 2012. The terracotta plough of the Harappan civilization was found at. The terracotta plough of the Harappan civilization was found at. It was found at the Haryana site of Banavali. Banavali, they have found a terracotta plough of the Harappan civilization. So these are the various important Indus Valley civilization sites, their archaeological significance, and we have also covered almost all the previous year question papers which were asked in various UPSC exams related to this topic. So thank you so much. Stay tuned. The next video we will continue about the art and architecture of Indus Valley civilization. So please do subscribe and share our channel. Dr. Rakesh Sharma signing off. Thank you so much.